In this video, we're going to learn some more methods of factoring trinomials of the form ax squared plus bx plus c. So let's say you are factoring 6x squared minus 11x plus 4. All right, so we've gone over how to do trial factors. Well, I'm going to ask you this question. What if you knew one of the correct factors was 3x minus 4? So if you were sure that that was one of the factors, could you figure out what the other missing factor was? All right. So keep in mind, I'm saying you definitely know 3x minus 4 is a factor. What would the other one be? Well, 3x times what will give you 6x squared? 2x. And negative 4 times what will give you 4? Negative 1. And then you can check this by doing the outer and inner terms and making sure that really does add up to a negative 11x, which it does, negative 3x and negative 8x. So that's your correct answer. So wouldn't that be nice if you were always given at least one of the correct terms? So let's see if you could do this one. Factor 18m squared minus 27m plus 4 if you know 6m minus 1 is one factor. So try this. You know 6m minus 1 is one of the factors, so what would the other factor be? Sorry, I'm trying to get 18m squared for my first term, so that must be 3m. And I'm trying to get a positive 4 for my last term. I have negative 1 times what will give me that positive 4? It'll have to be a minus 4. And then let's check and make sure this really is the correct factorization. You've already checked the first and last term. Let's do the outer and inner. We have negative 24m and negative 3m is negative 27m. So this is the correct factorization of this one. That's the correct factorization for that one. So the trick is, if you can figure out a way of getting one of the correct factors, it's not so hard to get the next one, but you make sure you do always check. Well, I have a sneaky way that I'm going to teach you, which is something you should do as scratch work, because if somebody looks at your work, they may not understand what you're doing, to get one of the correct factors. So here's how it goes. Okay, here's my tricky method. What you're going to do is use the product and sum idea, but the product is not the last number here. The product is you have to multiply the first coefficient times the last constant term. That's the product. So the product is 15 times 8, which is 120. Okay, so the product is 120, and the sum is still the middle coefficient. So let's write down numbers that we're trying to find two numbers that have a product of 120 and a sum of negative 22, which we've done before. So we've got 1 and 120, 2 and 60, 3 and 40, 4 and 30, 5, let's see, 5 goes into 30, 6 times 4 is 24, 6, 20, 7 does not go into any of those numbers, 8 does, 8 goes into 24, 3 times 5 is 15, that's how it came from originally, 15 times 8, let's see, 9 doesn't go into it, and 10 times 12. Those are all the possibilities. Sum is negative, right? So the bigger number has to be negative. And the product is positive, so the numbers have to have the same sign. So these numbers are going to also be negative. All right, so find two numbers that add up to negative 22, and there it is. All right, now what do we do from here? This is the sneaky part of the problem. You're going to start off with the first original term in the problem, 15x squared. So now you're going to write 15x squared. And one of these numbers, it doesn't matter which one, negative 10x. So you're going to take the middle term, which is negative 22x, and instead of writing the negative 22, that coefficient, you're going to write one of these numbers. So I'm going to choose the negative 10x. Okay, let me move this over a little bit. and change it to another color so it's easy to see. Okay, now you're going to factor these two terms. So 15x squared minus 10x by pulling out the greatest common factor, and that's 5x times x minus, I'm sorry, that is 5x times 3x minus 2. Correct? Whatever you just put in the parentheses is one of the correct factors. All right, so watch this. Now you know it's 3x minus 2. Let's figure out the other one. 3x times what will give you 15x squared? 5x. Negative 2 times what will give me positive 8? Negative 4. Let's check it. Does that give me the correct one? Look at that. I've got negative 12x, negative 10x. That does give me the negative 22x. Cool. That's a sneaky way of using the product and sum to get one of the correct factors. So I'm doing the product and sum. One huge difference is the product is the first coefficient times the constant at the end. You have to multiply those together. So that's not just 8, it's 120. I'll explain this later in another video, why this works. But let's just see how we can get the right answers for now. Here's another one. Factor 2x squared minus 27x minus 14. Remember, you don't have to use this method. You could just do trial factors and see if you get the correct answer. All right, so what I want to do is the product and sum again. Okay, so the product, remember we are going to multiply the first times the last term. And that's 2 times negative 14, which is negative 28. And the sum is the middle term, which is negative 27. Now, some of you might be able to come up with a correct answer right away here. 1 times 28 does it. Because if you put the negative in front of the bigger number and use the opposite sign since it's negative, this is going to be it. All right, but let's say you didn't know that, and you could always just list them all and then at that point, you could realize that it's going to be 1 in the negative 28. All right, so now, what's the next step? You take the first term over here, which is 2x squared. 2x squared, and you take one of these numbers. Doesn't matter which one. I'm going to do the 1 plus 1x. So remember, it's like you're writing this, the first two terms, but you're putting in the new number here, one of them, instead of the negative 27x. So you're only writing two terms. And then you factor out the greatest common factor. All right, well, it's just an x, which is 2x plus 1. That's one of the correct factors. So we go over here, 2x plus 1. All right, so what's the other factor? Well, 2x times what will give me 2x squared? X. And 1 times what will give me negative 14? Negative 14. And that should be the correct factorization. And you should check by going ahead and doing the FOIL method, making sure that gives you the correct inner and outer term, which it does. Now, what if you had chosen, I said it didn't matter which one you chose, whether you chose the plus 1 or the negative 28. So instead, what if you had taken the first term, 2x squared, and done it with a minus 28x? Always remember to write the x. So you're going to factor out at 2x, and that gives me x minus 14. That tells you that x minus 14 is one of the correct factors. And then we'd have to figure out the other one. X times what is 2x squared? And negative 14 times what is negative 14? It's 1. Well, that's equivalent. Both of those are exactly the same. That's the how to factor 2x squared minus 27x minus 14. So this is what I call the sneaky way of finding one of the correct factors. I'm going to stop this video now, and you can go on to the next video, and we'll do more examples.